I'm brainstorming ideas for my work in progress, but every time I want to use a model that isn't already attached to the system prompt, I have to go and manually do it myself. It's effort. To combat this, Novelcrafter has introduced model collections. Model collections are great because they allow us to control models across the app without having to go into each prompt and manually do it ourselves. So let's go and pin my chat to the side, split left, and I'm going to go into the prompt library. I'm doing this so that I can see my changes in real time rather than having to switch between chat and the prompt library. Novelcrafter comes with a default list of models for each prompt type. Each collection has been curated by us to give the best bang for your buck, since, for example, if you're doing a summarization prompt, you don't need the most expensive model in order to get a good result, whereas for prose generation, you often want the latest, best models. These collections have been curated using the most used models in chat at the time of creation, but what if we never use half of them? Or a new model comes out and we want to test it now. So we're going to make our own model collection. I'm going to go to prompt library, click plus new, and then model collection. And then we get a blank model collection. I'm going to name it, in this case, Kate's faves, as in my favorite models. A model in Novelcrafter isn't just the LLM. It's a combination of that LLM, GPT-5, Claude, etc., as well as custom settings for its parameters, for example, temperature. Let's select an LLM from our list. I'm going to go Claude Sonnet 4 and say I might want to give it a temperature of 0.5 for prompt adherence. And then I'm going to have a second version of that model with the default settings for temperature. I'm going to now take a moment to add a few more favorites. So I'll see you in a minute. And now we have the beginnings of my favorite model collection. I'm going to take a moment and rearrange them. For example, I want to have my Claude models together. So I'm going to click and drag, and I'll put Quen above GPT. I'll do it in order of use. I'm also going to remove in the name anything that is not needed for me to identify. For example, I just want to know what the model is called in these cases. So we've got that sorted there. You might be wondering why I'm ordering and if it's just kind of as a matter of preference, but this is also shown in this order when you go to the prompt itself. So I like to put the models that I use the most at the top so they're easier to find. Just below this is the prompts and presets section. Let's test our model collection out by attaching our collection to the general purpose chat prompt. And if we take a look down at the sidebar where we have our general chat here, as I click this, you can see that not only has it added to the prompts and presets section, we can see the model has changed as 4.0 mini is no longer in here. And if I click on it, we can see all of my Kate's faves are now in this section. But wait, where did all the other models go? Once you attach a custom collection to a system prompt, we assume that you no longer want or need the system defaults. So if you want to largely keep the models the same and only add or remove one or two models, it's easier to clone the system model collection. So we would want to go in this case to the chat models, clone, and then make our changes from this list. Okay, so we have our first prompt attached, but it can get a little bit tedious to add every single prompt at once. So let's add all our system prompts by clicking Attach to System Prompts. And then from there, we can take, say I don't want to use it on the default summarization prompts. I can detach from there so that if I go on to scene summarizations, the only model collection associated with it is the defaults, not Kate's faves. Whereas general purpose, we can see Kate's faves and the default writing models are shown. If we're working on a prompt, we can also go directly into that prompt and attach a collection from there. And it will show both here. And if we click on to go directly to the model collection, we can see it showing in the prompts and presets section as well. Now, new models come out all the time, sometimes multiple on the same day. I like to try them out, but I don't necessarily know if I want to commit, and I'm not going to put them in my favorites collection because I want to keep that clean and tidy. So rather than adding them individually to a prompt, I'm going to make a separate model collection by clicking new model collection for new models. Let's go add model. And let's say hypothetically, Grok 4 came out today. I might then add that to my new model collection and then attach it to the system prompts, remove the summarization again. And if I go now to check on my pinned chat, I can see that not only Kate's faves is showing, but also my new models collection. We can see both model collections at the same time. It's really super convenient. And if we add more models in real time, they can be added or removed, which really speeds up the process of testing out models. And there you have it. Model collections might seem like a niche feature, but once you start using them, you'll wonder how you ever live without them. For me, I really like them because they reduce decision fatigue. The model choices are made for me, and I don't have to play hide and seek to find the ones I want to use. Try creating a few based on your writing needs and see how they speed up your workflow. Until next time.